rose-colored glasses are off, it's time to get real. Yet, we remain hopeful. Still, this is the Marketing Disenchanted Podcast. I am your host, Temitayo A Osinubi. Let's get to it. Welcome to episode 10 of the Marketing Disenchanted Podcast. So, no guests this week, just me. I think the way I'm going to do the show is about every fifth episode or so, I'm going to do a solo cast where I discuss current topics in digital marketing. And this is going to give us an opportunity for me to share my thought leadership with you, as well as if there's any topics or discussions that you want to have or things that you want to hear on the podcast, shoot me an email at temi@consulttemi.com. That's T-E-M-I at consult. T-E-M-I.com. One of two things are going to happen. If it's something that I have a level of expertise on, I'll discuss it in one of these solo cast episodes. And if it's something I don't have an area of expertise on, I'll find a guest who does and have them on the show. So today's solo cast topic is going to be the three epiphanies that I had while getting a degree in internet marketing from Full Sail University. And I titled it The Three Epiphanies You Can't Get from Gary Vee, because Gary Vee doesn't have a degree in internet marketing. So because every podcast is somebody's first podcast, I want to take a step back and really discuss why it is that I'm calling Gary Vaynerchuk out in the title of this show, and why I wanted to have a discussion around this topic. So for those of you who don't know, in late 2016, while Gary Vee was in Canada, a guy named Richard asked him to give advice to his 17-year-old daughter, Kiara, about what she should do with regards to her college career, and to give her some pearls of wisdom to prepare her for the marketing world as Gary Vee sees it. And Gary Vee's answer was, and I quote, "Here's what I would say, Kiara. There is not a school on earth, not a university or a college that exists, that is even remotely equipped to educate you properly on communications and marketing in the world we live in today," end quote. He then goes on to describe a college education as a shit product, extortion, and effed up effing crazy ass shit. As the audience hoops and hollers, and he proceeds to just tell this girl to treat the next 4 years like a big vacation, hook up with a lot of guys, and just a bunch of irreverent, crazy stuff that only Gary Vee can get away with because, you know, he's developed that brand of irreverence. So, a lot to unpack here. I love Gary Vee. Let me say that first and foremost, but something important that I would say to Kiara, as well as any young professional who is sort of wrapped up in the limelight surrounding this guy, is that you need to understand that Gary Vaynerchuk has never actually been through the process of getting a degree in internet marketing. And I refer to people like Gary Vee, who give advice about things that they haven't actually been through themselves, as male gynecologists, right? And I say that with utmost respect. I have three children, and all three of them were delivered by a male gynecologist. So I don't mean to use that example to say that, you know, they don't know what they're talking about or not, or that they're not experts. Not at all. Quick story, my mid-child, Gabby, she had to be delivered via emergency C-section because her umbilical cord was wrapped around her head. So every time my ex contracted, Gabby's heart rate would drop precipitously. And I'll never forget this for as long as I live. So my ex had to be induced, and we were trying to go natural, you know, vaginally. And so we're in there waiting, and Dr. Fraser comes in with another doctor whose name escapes me, and about two other nurses and an orderly or an intern or whatever, and all six of them come in, and he eases up to my ex real close and, you know, puts his hand on her shoulder, and he, you know, talks to her very gently and says, "The baby's in distress. We got to go and get her. I know you wanted to deliver naturally, but we're not able to do that. We're gonna have you in surgery in 5 minutes. Only two people can go back there. Decide which two people are gonna go, and I'll see you in 5 minutes." And they turn around and leave. So we're starting to freak out, of course, because he didn't actually explain what was wrong. We didn't learn that her cord was wrapped around her head until afterwards, because, you know, there wasn't time to, you know, have this long drawn out conversation. He had to go get the baby. And so like 90 seconds later, this nurse comes in, is like, okay, which two of you are going to go back in surgery? And then another nurse comes in and she wheels my ex off to get her prepared for surgery. So, you know, I put on the gown and everything and I get ready. About 3.5 minutes later, I'm standing in the hallway, and then they let us into the operating room. And about 4 minutes and 15 seconds after he first walked in, they're cutting and going to get my daughter. So, you know, that was a very stressful situation, an emergency C-section, but Dr. Fraser treated it like just another day at the office for him, because it was. Dr. Fraser was in his late 60s at the time. He's probably in his early 70s by now, because my daughter's 3, and he was playing Papa Was a Rolling Stone by the Temptations in the operating room, and we're just like, really, dude? That's what you're gonna play? And he's like, what's the matter? You don't like the Temptations? I can put on something else. And, you know, it just really calmed everything down as he, you know, performed the operation and got my daughter. And so I say all of that to say that I am not of the opinion that, you know, just because you didn't go through a process doesn't mean that you don't have expertise, because Dr. Fraser, Dr. Percy Fraser, he has been delivering babies literally for the last 45 years, and he's a, you know, expert at what he does. And if you have a high risk pregnancy in particular, you definitely want those practice hands working on you. That being said, at the end of the day, Percy Fraser is a man. So he himself has never actually been on the other side of the operating table. He's performed a lot of C-sections, but he doesn't know what it feels like to have a C-section because, you know, he's a guy. He doesn't have the physiology to go through that. And I would say the same thing about Gary Vaynerchuk with regards to the advice that he gave Kiara. Gary Vaynerchuk, he is a marvel of our modern marketing times. He's done phenomenal things with VaynerMedia, and I look up to him myself. That being said, at the end of the day, he has never actually been through the process that he's talking about, because he does not have a degree in internet marketing. Okay, so that is something that I want you to take into consideration, Kiara.
John Lee Dumas of the Entrepreneur on Fire podcast, he's another one. I listen to his podcast on a regular basis, and he said on several occasions that all college gets you is debt. And I love you, John. I'm an avid Fire Nation member, but, you know, speak for your own major, dude. If you don't have a degree in internet marketing, don't make blanket statements talking about how college, all college gets you is debt, because that simply isn't the case. John Lee Dumas has said that he's about 180 from Gary Vaynerchuk, because Gary Vaynerchuk had previously said that he doesn't agree with young life coaches, because he thinks that life coaches in their 20s haven't really experienced enough life to actually be someone's life coach. Whereas John Lee Dumas, when he was in his 20s, he had already been to war and experienced PTSD. So he most certainly did have the experience in his 20s to coach someone through PTSD, because he himself had been through it. And so I'm about 180 from John Lee Dumas and Gary Vaynerchuk on a college education in internet marketing, because this is something that I myself have been through that neither one of them have. So love them both, respect them both, but this whole all college gets you is debt, and what Gary Vee told Kiara, I just don't agree with it. Respect you, love you, but no.
So something important that I want to touch on before we go any further is the difference between facts and beliefs. Right, because this is very important, the difference between facts and beliefs. Now, when Gary gave his response, he prefaced it by saying, here's what I would say, Kiara. Now, to me, that tells me that he's expressing an opinion, right? This is Gary Vee's opinion. He's not saying this is what is a fact, but he's saying it's an opinion. But then he goes on to say, you know, make a what we call a declarative statement. Right? Like, he's making a declaration. So even though he prefaced it like an opinion, he kind of stated it like a fact. And so I want to make very clear that he's entitled to his opinion. He's entitled to his beliefs. However, to say that there's not a school on earth there's not a university that exists that is even remotely equipped to educate you properly on marketing in the world we live in today. That is not true. That is not a fact. The fact of the matter remains that there most certainly are degree programs that you can get from accredited colleges and universities in internet marketing. And I want to make this very clear. I'm not talking about a regular MBA or a regular marketing degree where you might have a class or semester on social media and digital marketing. No, I'm talking about an actual degree where your declared major is internet marketing, like the one I got from Full Sail University. So from semester one through graduation, solely digital marketing, right? Now, that being said, you do not have to accept the validity of the degree, right? Because I have been told on several occasions that digital marketing changes too fast and you got hustled and blah, blah, blah. And you know what? People are entitled to their opinions and their beliefs, but it's just that, their opinions and beliefs, and that does not change facts. Like, there are people to this day, as I'm recording this in late 2016, that still believe that President Barack Obama is not a U.S. citizen, that he's a Muslim, and all of this other nonsense, including his successor, right? Including the person who's coming after him. He's one of the ones that demanded to see his birth certificate too. However, the fact remains that regardless of what you think or believe about the man, President Barack Obama most certainly is a United States citizen, and he served as president for two terms. And I would say the same thing about degrees in digital marketing. Regardless of what Gary Vaynerchuk thinks, regardless of what he believes, the fact of the matter is that you most certainly can go to a college or a university like Full Sail University and get a degree in internet marketing. Gary Vee is entitled to his opinions and beliefs. He can think or feel whatever the hell he wants, but that in no way, shape, form, or fashion changes the facts, right? It's kind of like how Neil deGrasse Tyson feels about religion. Neil deGrasse Tyson is a famous astrophysicist, and he's also an atheist. And his views on religion is that you're entitled to your beliefs. You're entitled to believe what you want to believe. The problem comes in when you start prostituting your beliefs as facts, and they're not. And the great thing about science is that something's either a fact or it's not. Your belief is not necessary, right, for something to be a fact. And that's really what I want to say about Gary Vee's opinion. He's entitled to his opinion, but please, please, please do not confuse his opinion with facts, because the fact of the matter is that they do teach this at a college level, and it is relevant today. As someone who has been through the process and does have a degree in internet marketing, I'm going to share with you three epiphanies that I had while going through the degree program. We're going to take a short break, and I'll be right back. In the last 3 months of the 2016 U.S. presidential election, fake news outperformed real news on Facebook. Now, don't worry. This is a podcast about marketing, not politics. But what I'm trying to pull out with that example is that most people can't call BS online when they see it. Now, this is in stark contrast to the whole un-college movement that favors finding information online, oftentimes for free, as opposed to paying for higher education. Now, that tactic can work, assuming you can call BS when you see it, which unfortunately most people just can't. The ability to call BS online, what we call digital discernment, is a skill, which means that it can be learned. Go to bit.ly.com/DMD course to learn the skill of digital discernment. In this short course, taught by yours truly, I condense my over a decade of trial and error experience, as well as the skill I learned getting a degree in digital marketing for your benefit. Go to bit.ly.com/DMD course right now. That's bit.ly/D as in dog, M as in Mary, D as in dog course. And we're back. So The first epiphany that I had while getting a degree in internet marketing from Full Sail University is how very inept I was at both locating and discerning valid information online when I saw it. Right? So the very first class they make you take at Full Sail when you're getting a degree in internet marketing is called digital literacy. And the whole point of the class is to really teach you, to get you familiarized with the online platform, how to submit assignments, and most importantly, how to do research and what you can submit as research and what you can't. And they tell you flat out, in not so many terms, that Wikipedia, Huffington Post, these are not credible sources. If you submit a paper with Wikipedia as a source, you get an F. Right? They don't say it like that, but more or less, that's what they're saying. And this is really important in terms of, you know, figuring out what's a credible source and what's not, because something I mentioned in the commercial break that you just heard, if you didn't, you know, skip through it at 1.5 time, is that in the last 3 months of the 2016 U.S. presidential election, fake news outperformed real news on Facebook. Now, this is just to say that, you know, people really can't distinguish the real from the fake unless they're taught, right? This is in stark contrast to the whole un-college movement that just says, you know, go to Google, figure it out, sift out good information, don't bother going to college. You know, there's a near catastrophic level of delusion of people's ability to actually do that. Right? It's kind of like this old case study. They surveyed a bunch of college students back in the 80s, and 80% of college students back then said that they were above average drivers. And they did it again, and 93% of college students said that they were above average drivers. Now, this is a statistical impossibility, right? You cannot have an overwhelming majority like that be above average, because then there is no average. Right? But this is how people view their abilities to search out and identify valid information online. Most people think that they're proficient at it, and they're just not. They're just not proficient at it. There's this pre-internet saying that you can't polish a turd. Ha! I laugh every time I hear that. Not only can you polish a turd, but I can turn a turd into Cinderella with my skill set.
I mean, all you need is a slick WordPress theme that's going to set you back about $50, some good ad copy. I can make a turd do acrobatics, the hell with polishing it up. The second major epiphany I had while going through the degree program was that I had picked up a bunch of bad habits teaching myself internet marketing while meandering the wilds of Google that I didn't necessarily appreciate for what they were at the time that I was picking them up, because I felt like I was just learning the game from somebody who knew the game. Right. And so as I was teaching myself these skills, I inadvertently had picked up, some bad teachers that I lacked the ability to discern, as I previously mentioned in the first epiphany. So while matriculating through the program, Full Sail gradually had to break me of these bad habits that I didn't even know that I had. Like me, for example, I didn't even know what a black hat was until I came to Full Sail in 2012, because none of these gurus / mavens / ninjas actually come out and tell you that they're a black hat. What they will say is that they know how to make money and the things that they do work. And black hat does work. It absolutely works until it doesn't. And so because of that, it didn't really dawn on me that I was learning something that wasn't above board. I just felt like I was learning the game from somebody who knew the game, right? So as an example, say that you're a 16-year-old boy going through puberty, your father's out of the house, so he's not around to teach you about girls, and you learn the ways of the opposite sex from a pimp. And I ain't just talking about some smooth-talking player either. No, I'm talking about an actual putting hoes on a track, bitch better have my money or I'll bust your head to the white meat show, pimp, right? Now, if you're 16 and all you're thinking about is getting them panties off, a pimp most certainly can teach you how to do that.
Now, you're going to pick up a bunch of bad habits along the way, and a pimp can't actually teach you how to be a husband, how to be respectful toward women, how to be a good guy, right? No, all you're interested in is having sex. And if that's what you're interested in, a pimp can teach you how to do that, no question. The same goes for these digital pimps. If all you're interested in is making money, then a digital pimp, a black hat, can certainly teach you those skills. But again, you're gonna pick up a bunch of bad habits along the way, and you're not necessarily going to be in a position to actually have a real business, to be a responsible digital citizen, because black hats can't teach you that, just like a pimp can't teach you how to be a husband to a respectable woman. So anytime you have an industry that can get as shady as digital marketing can, it's important to not only educate consumers so that they don't get taken advantage of, but it's also important to educate practitioners so that they don't inadvertently become predators. Take somebody like a Joe Polish, right? Joe Polish was a carpet cleaner by trade, and not unlike digital marketing, professional carpet cleaning can get really sleazy in terms of marketing practices. So they'll advertise that they'll clean your entire house for $20. They get there and they clean one spot, typically in the middle of your floor, and they'll get that really clean to the point where it stands out against the rest of your filthy floor. And they're like, oh, you want me to clean their whole room? No. That was just, that $20 was just for that one spot. If you want us to clean the entire house, that'll be $500, right? Really sleazy. Easy stuff like that. And so what Joe Polish did is he started Piranha Marketing, where he teaches ethical marketing practices to carpet cleaners in an effort to raise the profile of carpet cleaners as a whole, because as an ethical carpet cleaner, he was having a hard time competing against these unethical people who are basically just tricking people, right? And so professional digital marketing education from a university absolutely has a part to play in raising the profile of the professional digital marketer, because not unlike carpet cleaning, there are parts of the web that is a proper cesspool. And if you're not careful, you're going to pick up a lot of bad habits and not even know it. And so the third and last epiphany that I had while going through the degree program is how very broad and expansive the industry was, that I didn't really appreciate beforehand. So like most people, I equated digital marketing to social media, right? If you said you did digital marketing, my knee jerk was, oh, you do Facebook. But there are entire subsets of the professional digital marketing landscape that have nothing at all to do with social media. So going back to the medical example, you should think of digital marketing like the medical industry, and that is very broad, and there are several areas of specialization. So for example, as a medical doctor, you can be a heart surgeon, brain surgeon, OBGYN, podiatrist, ear, nose, and throat doctor. There's just a billion different ways that you can go as a professional doctor. The same can be said as a professional digital marketer. You can specialize in SEO, PPC, mobile, affiliate marketing. There are several different things that you can do in professional digital marketing that have absolutely nothing to do with social media. And if you're teaching yourself digital marketing, that's an appreciation that you're not necessarily going to have. So Kiara, if you're listening, here's what I would say to you. I would say that you should really figure out where in the digital landscape you want to occupy. There's some really good resources that I can point you to. You should actually listen to episode 1 of this podcast, where I go into details about the actual pros and cons of getting a degree in internet marketing. And again, this is from the perspective of someone who actually has one. I would also point you to my ultimate digital marketing college guide. That can be of a lot of help to you. And just giving you some very frank Gary Vee style advice, college is expensive. It is not inexpensive. I had to borrow the better part of $60,000 to get my degree in internet marketing. Now, I would say that the investment is absolutely worth it, but you know, that's a lot of money. That's a lot of debt to take on. So you might really want to think about alternate ways of getting that education if you're not comfortable with that level of debt. There's some really good resources that you can get a hold of. Lynda.com has some really good trainings. A Marketing Profs B2B Forum is a good conference to go to. And there's one in particular, Funnel Hacking Live by ClickFunnels. Our final project, the full sale, essentially is funnel hacking, right? There's a little bit more to it. That's not exactly it. But if you can funnel hack, you can pass your final exam. That being said, that conference, Funnel Hacking Live, is going to be about, depending on when you buy it, if you have early bird pricing, it's going to be anywhere from $700 to $1,000. That does not include your flight, your hotel, Uber, food for however many days. So after you add all that stuff back in, you're looking at between $3,000 and $5,000 to attend Funnel Hacking Live. Also, there is going to be an upsell from the stage as you're there for a private VIP coaching program or mastermind, something of that nature. And in my experience, those can be upwards of $10,000. So again, because you have two parents in the household, I don't know what your finances look like. I would say to you that it might be advantageous for you to go to Funnel Hacking Live as opposed to getting a degree in internet marketing. I don't know. It really depends, again, on which rung of the digital marketing ladder that you want to occupy and what your career goals are. So I really hope that this episode was helpful to you, Kiara, because this one was for you in specific, as well as any other young professionals who have questions about, you know, the professional digital marketing landscape. And again, no diss to Gary Vaynerchuk. I'm a fan of Gary Vaynerchuk. I have deep respect for him, just like I have deep respect for Dr. Percy Frazier, who delivered my first two children. But again, male gynecologists don't actually know what it's like to go through the process themselves. And Gary Vee does not actually know what it's like to get a degree in internet marketing, because he does not have a degree in internet marketing, whereas I do. And yeah, hope this helped. Hope this provide a different point of view and a different perspective. Until then, guys, later. Have you ever been paralyzed while doing research? You go to Google, you type in your search query, and seconds later, you're hit with millions, if not billions, of search results, and you can't make heads or tails out of any of them. Overwhelmed and afraid you'll make the wrong choice, you don't make any choice at all. Well, friends, you're not alone, but you needn't suffer in silence. The ability to make sense out of what you find online, and more importantly, call BS when you see it, is a skill, which means that it can be learned. Go to bit.ly.com/DMD course right now to learn the skill of digital discernment. In this short course, taught by yours truly, I condense my over a decade of trial and error experience, as well as what I've learned getting a degree in internet marketing, for your benefit. Go to bit.ly.com/D as in dog, M as in Mary, D as in dog course. One more time, bit.ly.com/DMD course. Thank you for doing me the high honor of listening to the very end. Please subscribe in iTunes, Stitcher, or your favorite podcasting app. Leave a 5-star rating and write a review telling people about my unmitigated awesomeness. It really helps out with getting the show shown. Follow me on Twitter at Tembo8482. That's T-E-M-B as in boy, O-8482. Or connect on LinkedIn, and I'll have my LinkedIn description in the show notes. And I'll see you next week.